On tonight's show, we go back to Route 66 and continue our road trip series and end it at the Santa Monica Pier in Los Angeles as we continue on historic Route 66. Next on America's number one road trip television show, it's Jann Scott Tonight. Now in Arizona, in New Mexico. Nope, Arizona. Well, we're on Jackrabbit Road here. This is the Jackrabbit Trading Post, one of the old, curious places to visit on Route 66. The Jackrabbit.
Yeah.
Come on, me. So, one. Oh, tell us the story now. Who owns this? How long has it been there?
Well, the store started Jackrabbit in 1949, started by Jim Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
And he's still living. He's down in Sun City, Arizona. And he still remembers us.
Yeah.
Like a great grandfather. He's really a special guy. And he leased it to my granddad, 1961, after he got out of the Senate. Well, he was still in it, but getting out of it.
Your granddad was in the Senate?
Senator, yeah, for 10 years.
From Arizona?
Navajo County, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He then bought it in 67, sold it to my parents in 1969, and then my husband and I in 1995.
Now, is there such a thing as a real jackrabbit that's that big?
Not that big. They're pretty big out here. We don't see too many anymore like we used to.
What happened to them all? They
well,
get ate
I think
by wolves?
The freeway and animals, coyotes.
Oh,
there
yeah.
Lots of coyotes out there and stuff. And people just hunting them. We see them mostly at nighttime with our headlight spotlight or something.
Grab it. It's Jann Scott's Great American Road Trip across Route 66, headed west.
At different videos we've been in that have been Country by Malcolm Martin Murphy or Rock, I'm not sure who all they've been. We've been in Porsche commercials and a few movies back in the olden days. We've had movie stars come in. James Woods for one, he's kind of a neat guy. And we've had Merle Haggard, a country singer.
What was James Woods doing here?
He was going to be on a or film for a movie in Colorado. Or Albuquerque, maybe? In New Mexico, maybe. That's what it was, New Mexico. And he stopped in and did just a little bit of shopping with a friend of his. And then he headed out.
On what's left, 66. Now a lot of misery's rattled down that road. From a trail of tears to watching the population explode.
Twin Arrows is a small truck stop and an 8-stool diner. Left from Route 66, truckers still stop here. When are they going to reopen the cafe?
Well, last September. They've been working on it for a long time, so
Hopefully in the next month or so.
And 54 or 5?
It's a 55 or 56 Oldsmobile there. So.
Yeah.
So it was new then, huh?
Mm-hmm. Probably brand new.
Twin Arrows?
No, I'm from Texas.
Oh.
I just moved here, so.
Why?
Because I wanted to...
Get out of Texas?
Well, I always wanted to move to Arizona, so.
But this is Twin Arrows. Some, there are like, what, five people that live here?
There's five or six ranches around here.
Oh.
And the owners have Padre Canyon Ranch out here, so.
Oh, yeah.
I just ran out of gas right here, and this is where I got a job.
Really?
Yeah. Kind of a weird situation, but I walked in and they were needing somebody, so.
That's kind of a historic Route 66 story.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, we have our regulars, you know, like the ABF companies and that kind of thing. They all like to stop, and Virginia has some really great homemade brownies back there, so they're addictive. They all come in for the brownies.
Well, nice talking to you.
Thanks.
This is a famous coffee crown. Non-dairy creamer. That's what I like about Route 66. You get this stuff right here. This is good. As long as you take a lot of fiber. From the Twin Arrows here in Twin Arrows, population 5, on historic Route 66.
So 1950? Route 66?
Oh, yeah. Lived in Albuquerque since 52.
Oh, yeah. Can you tell us about it? Tell us, you got any stories about Route 66?
Oh, there's still too many even to get.
Start with one.
Well, this used to be a very narrow and very difficult route to go across here. It used to take 8 solid hours as hard as you could go from Albuquerque to Flagstaff. Now you can make it in 5.5.
Oh, yeah. 1950. Oh.
There's lots of roads around up here that you can only see from the freeway. And, but it's interesting traveling around up here because there's a lot of history in this country, particularly right in this area.
Like what?
Well, this Winona up here has been a spot on the railroad all these years.
Yeah.
And it's been a place for folks to stop and wait when the road gets bad.
Mm-hmm. So you think of a memorable Route 66 story.
Where it's called a freeway now, it's called Ashford.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes from Williams down to Ashford. Although it used to be a two-lane road. Most of the old roads you can't drive on anymore. But I've been across, there was 2 lanes from top to bottom, it was 10 miles, 4 to 6% grade all the way through. It was the kind of equipment we had in those days. Why, it was pretty tough getting across there.
Mm.
The most famous place is out west of Kingman.
Mm.
On the old highway up at what they call Oakman Pass.
Oh, yeah. Have you driven Oakman Pass?
Yeah.
In a big rig?
In a big rig, but we didn't haul for 28,000 pounds up there because we tried that in the daytime while you'd burn your truck right up.
How long were the trailers back then?
32, 35 foot.
32 or 35. And what kind of shifters did you have?
We used 5s and 3s most of us.
That means 2 levers, right?
2 levers.
You were a busy guy.
Well, that's the only way we could get going.
Tell me, what now?
Well, right after the war, of course, all we had was military equipment that had been built for the war. We changed things around, modified a little bit for civilian use. Those days, mostly spent my time in California. When we started across here, there wasn't really a good serviceable road for full loads from L.A. up through Flagstaff this way, unless we came around down south and came through Blythe, over to Wickenburg and straight up over the mountain that way.
Now, have you driven Route 66 from L.A. to Chicago?
Oh, yes.
How many times have you been across it?
Many times. I just run from Albuquerque to Cayman now. That's all I do.
Yeah. So if truck drivers complain about the new highways, they should have been on the old 66. Huh? You got any opinion on that?
Well, I think these new roads are great. What I've seen, changes I've seen out here, most of the younger fellows haven't seen them, so of course they have no reference point.
Yeah.
I can tell you, it used to be a hard job. It used to be, it took, like I said, it took you 8 solid hours as hard as you could drive. And there was road on old Highway 66 east of Holbrook, between Holbrook and the Gallup. It used to be a very, very treacherous thing and extremely rough. Mm. There were only 2 lanes wide, You can still see some pieces of it, bits and pieces out there. And a lot of history out here. A lot of folks came out to California to try to find a better way to live. We used to still run with those folks in the 50s, still going out there.
What was the first year you had CBs?
I'll have to think about that. Well, at Navajo Freight, which is what our company was, then we started getting involved in those in about the mid-60s. And that was back when your license cost you $20 a year. And you had a fellas watching you all the time. If they heard any foul language on there, they'd pull your license and confiscate your radio. Of course, as you know, today it's not like that.
Mm-hmm.
Not a whole lot because of the traffic, because of the, how rough it was, but once in a while you could run about 60. And some of the guys, of course, nowadays they run 70, 75, 80. Mm-hmm. Most big companies, like the one I serve, we run about 60, a little under 60 mile an hour, that's it. Right now, about five, my personal safety mission, safety record is about 5.57 million. And this is not a new card, but these numbers on here are valid. My number I'll put on here.
Okay.
I'm driving this old 66 since 1950. I've been in the trucking industry since 1946. And I've personally driven about 5.56 million miles.
Winona, that's good.
Well, it's, like I say, it's not divisional. It's been, that has been there for a while. The Highway 66 used to turn right there at Winona
mm-hmm.
and go in on what's called Towns Winona Road
mm-hmm.
In mid-89 out there by Mary's Cafe. But the old original Winona, when you go off the off-ramp, you look down by the railroad, and I don't know if they tore it out or not, but the old original place was down there.
Mm-hmm.
And then Towns Winona was the actual 66 originally going in town. Then they changed it and they put it straight through where it's at, just about where it's at now. And that's when that one there, it's there now, I think, mm-hmm. was built. But about 40 years now, since 1957.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Roger Pabat, and I lived here actually since I was 16 years old. I'm 57 now.
All right. And did you have you driven on Route 66 yourself?
Yeah, I used to drive it out this way. Matter of fact, I even worked out here when they first done the survey and the work just before they built I-40 to replace 66. Mm-hmm. I worked out of a state yard right here. At east of the building right here, and survey work, final survey just before they started the actual construction.
So Winona, where it is right now, is not where it originally was.
No,
hmm.
No, it's
not very many people know that, do they?
No, if you're westbound as you go off the off ramp, it was down on the flat down just before you get. Clear up on the overpass now. It's down on the flat down below. There's not too many of us older people are still around out here.
Yeah.
But, I guess they do pretty good too. So I have a friend of mine that was killed out here in Diablo there, two mm-hmm. arrows. It's when it was only one bridge, two-lane highway, mm-hmm. and he'd been drinking, and he'd been to our house in Flagstaff. When he went to, left there, we told him not to drive. He had two hitchhikers with him, and he let one of them drive until they got away from our place and down the station, and when he filled up with gas, and then he took the wheel, and he was coming east here. Headed east, and he tried to pass the semi on that bridge, and he met another one going the other way,
mm-hmm.
and that was the end of that one. But he was driving a trailer pull.
Oh yeah,
pulling house trailers. Four scump.
Yeah.
And then I've met a lot of film crews and stuff that have done.
Forrest Gump was filmed here.
Part of it, yeah.
Which part do they do?
Well, the part that. Where he got splashed in the face, and wipe it off the towel. He had a smile on his face.
Oh, yeah.
That was dug, and they dug a hole, and that hole still exists out here in front of the cafe to make a pawn for him to do that. So they hired a truck driver, gave him $200 to splash him in the face. He couldn't do it, so they give a guy $50, use a bucket and do it off camera.
So what's this now?
Oh, this is made splash across the building.
Right here. Yeah,
they dug it out and it just keeps the salt going down.
Right here at the Twin Arrows with Roger at the Twin Arrows. Forrest Gump was here in, I don't know, Route 66, huh? Well, this is Winona. The only thing that's much left of it is this bridge in back of us. And, of course, Winona Ryder was named after the town of Winona. And then Bobby Troup made Winona popular in his favorite famous song, Get Your Kicks on Route 66. Don't forget Winona.
St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City, looks mighty pretty, you'll see.
Well, we're at Flagstaff, Arizona. Now, Route 66 goes right by the historic Grand Canyon Cafe.
Here in downtown Flagstaff on Route 66. Okay, so what's the, so where are we?
We're at the Museum Club in Flagstaff, Arizona.
Yeah.
It was built in 1931, and we're open daily from 12 noon to 1 a.m., and you come on in, and Elridge was his name, and he was a taxidermist, and he built it for his taxidermist shop and a trading post for the Indians, and also as a museum, with oddities and things in here from all parts of the world. And It opened in 1931. In 1936, it became a bar, and now it's a dance club and bar.
You get a lot of cowboys in here?
Yes. Lots of nice ones.
Nice cowboys. That's good.
And famous people, Willie Nelson has played here. So, really? And we have visitors like Glenn Campbell and Robert De Niro has been here. And a few others, I can't remember all their names.
Oh, yeah. Now, what are on the walls? So I'm going to take pictures of them later, but what are
right
some of the things?
Right over on that, at the beginning by the stand over there, check stand, it shows the very beginning of the building being built around.
What kind of animals do you have?
Oh, we have elk, bear, bobcats, wild turkeys, boars, you name it, they're there.
All right.
You can take pictures of all of it.
I'm going to take pictures.
And it's largest log cabin in Arizona.
Oh, is it real logs?
Pardon?
Real logs, real log cabin.
Yes. Right. Yes, it is.
Oh, now tell me about the ghosts.
It's haunted.
Has anybody ever seen the ghost?
It is very true. Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Are you sure? Is it just a hallucination?
No, it's not a hallucination. It's really haunted. Right. There's been a program made on unsolved mysteries of the
building. Kidding me.
No. And the stories on that.
Oh, so what's the story about the ghosts?
The two owners were the, what was their name? Oh, Scotts. The Scotts. John Scotts and his wife are the ghosts here.
They both died in a building.
They both died here, and they are now haunted.
I know, he looks like he's...
Old skill, dang it.
You got any stories about this place? Any ever see any big bar fights in here?
Yeah, they tell about ghosts about this place.
Yeah.
Long ago, there were some people who had died here. I don't know as a result of fires, gunshot wounds, and whatnot. But they say they still kind of hover around the roof area. Who knows? Every once in a while, you know, you'll see see your bottle just kind of all of a sudden slide. And, you know, if it's just getting too many, or if the building is tilting, or what.
Right. Or it was all the popcorn jumping out of the dish.
Yeah, the grease.
Is that true?
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Get your kicks on what's left.
We're at the Museum Club here in Flagstaff, Arizona. The place is haunted and has lots of wild animals on the wall. Jann Scott live from Flagstaff on historic highway, Route 66.
We're going to be in big trouble here. I can feel it coming.
It's New Year's Eve.
Yeah,
Happy New Year.
It's the Cowboy Bar. And a lot of rednecks here. Of course, my people are redneck people, so I'll fit right
in. We have Redneck the Band here tonight.
Right.
Celebrating the New Year.
And Roger, our cameraman, he's a redneck.
On what's left, 56.
Smoke it up, smoke it.
Flagstaff, Arizona, on Route 66.
Just off Route 66, near Truxton, is the Grand Canyon, not a half a mile away.
We are 1 mile off the Indian reservation.
Do you throw them out when they get tough?
Yes, they call me Grandma. Yeah, I'm Grandma to them. So
they listen to you, huh?
When I raise my voice.
Yes, it is very, very pretty.
You ever get lonely living up here? It's pretty far out of the way.
Not really, because I stay busy all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I work both of us, so I stay real busy most of the time. Picture that sign over there. They're going to use the telephone. That was a fellow that came by broke, and he painted this sign over there.
With the guitar?
The lady there and the girl.
In the bathing suit?
Uh-huh.
Oh, in the evening gown with the guitar, whatever she has there. Who is the other one?
Well, that's the same one.
Miss Truxton.
Uh-huh. She's the first.
Miss 66 from Truxton, uh-huh. Right there.
Yes. When we started this event.
What's that now?
That's the stepfather, mother-in-law, cousin, and myself.
Where are you?
I'm the one over on the end.
On the right, yeah. Okay, go ahead.
This is my husband and Bobby Truth when he came 1 year. I can't remember the year. But anyway, it's a photographer out of Las Vegas, a newspaper. Up here, High Indian Reservation.
Mm-hmm.
My husband entered there. Him and my grandson entered in the parade.
All these pictures of cattle and sheep.
This is different animals that my husband and I purchased. It's the 4-H.
What'd you do with them?
What we do is we serve them here. After we buy them.
Now wait a minute, this guy right over here, that big guy?
Potato and yams, mashed potatoes and yams. Mmm.
And your dessert will be banana pudding.
Oh, yeah. Banana pudding for dessert.
Made by a 90-year-old mother-in-law.
Did you know this pig right here? Was this from a local ranch? No.
I'm afraid not.
No. Okay. No pig farmers around here, just sheep and cattle, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't mean to insult you. It's
okay.
Leave the pig farmers to the Oklahomans. Mm-hmm. You think?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned dinner. My foster mother taught me how to cook all these things.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. She was a Southern lady from Texas.
Oh.
We're in Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
Yes.
So you came here from Oklahoma in a wagon.
No.
You were part of the Dust Bowlers.
I was. Uh-huh.
You were?
Yes, I was. I was in the Dust Bowl area, but I came here originally from New Mexico, but I was born and raised in Oklahoma.
It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66.